Today we're taking a look at the CAT S22 Flip. This is a flip phone device that is going to make a lot of people happy. Essentially, it's an AGM M7 in a flip phone form factor. It has a touchscreen and a lot of smart features if you need them, but if you don't, then you have a perfect, excellent device that works flawlessly as well. Now, the CAT S22 Flip, being a rugged device, is a little bit heavier than your regular flip phone or than your regular phone, so that it may not be for everybody, but I really like the construction. It feels great in the hand. The materials are very good. You feel that ruggedness, of course, and the buttons are very clicky, very responsive. So I like the overall intent of the device. And of course, if you need those smart features, it has a touchscreen for it, but we'll get to that in just a second. Now, this device excites me a lot because it's based in the United States. So it's for the American market, it's for North America. We have the AGM M7 that is for the global market. It has three variants, it works very well. But here in the United States, sometimes you have different bands that it may work and it may not. And this device works excellently with VoLTE, with Vo Wi-Fi on T-Mobile, and you can also unlock it to use on other networks. And that's something that really makes me happy because sometimes we don't have a lot of options, especially if you're crossing over to Verizon or some of the other carriers. The device has most of the bands necessary to operate in the United States. It may be a little bit more difficult with Verizon, but once you get it unlocked, of course, you have to pay full price. We'll get to that in just a second, but it works very good. Call quality was superb. Speakers are very loud. I really enjoyed using the device for the basic functions. Text messaging works also very good with group text messaging and regular text messaging, downloading pictures. Essentially, it's an Android 11 Go flip phone. And for that, it has a lot of the basic functionality, hotspot, and of course, it has internet. You can install applications, things of that nature. The only drawback is that it may be too smart to a certain degree to be considered a proper dumb phone, but this is more of like a migration device, something that you're using in order to reduce that friction as you become more digital minimalist, or for someone who needs something that is very rugged, but you still need maps, you still need signal, you still need WhatsApp, things of that nature, but you just don't want to, you know, have a kind of like a screen crack or something like that. I work, if you work in construction or things of that nature, this still gives you that capability to have that ruggedness. And at the same time, it also has that beautiful screen that you're able to use. Now, it does have access to ADB, it does have access to the developer options, so you can sideload as many applications as you want. The device actually comes with the Google Play Store. I know some of you don't like that, but for those of you who need the Google Play Store, then it comes with it. It has a lot of proprietary things as well with T-Mobile, but you can remove them given that we have access to ADB, given that we have access to remove all of those packages that are unnecessary for the phone to actually work. So I'm really excited about this device because it's the best of both worlds. It has that ruggedness, it has that flip phone feel, and excellent battery life, but it also has those extra features if you need them, and you can download them properly without any extra things that are tracking you. You can remove what you don't need. You can also add those things that you want to add, and you can install probably different software. You can do the OEM unlock, so you can create software for it if you are a developer. So I'm really excited about the prospect of this device. Now, there's a couple of things that I did not like, and first is the weight of the device. Now, it's very well constructed, even though this flap right here on the side for the USB-C sometimes comes away, but you know, you just push it back and you're good to go. But on top of that, the weight of the device is quite hefty. Now, I've tried different rugged devices in the past. I've had the Kyocera Direx V Extreme. I've had the AGM M7, and you've seen them here in the reviews, but this one is even heavier than those. I think it's just because of the battery. It's quite a large battery, and the battery life is excellent, about 3 days without no issues, even while using some of the smarter features. Of course, you can drain it faster. It depends on your usage, but I will say a good benchmark will be 2 to 3 days because it has excellent reception. You can use it with Vo Wi-Fi. You can save a ton of battery. So I really enjoy using this device for that. Now, again, that heftiness, it's kind of something that you need to battle with if you want this device. I would say go test it at a store, at a T-Mobile store, and see if it's for you. Or maybe once it becomes available on Amazon, you'll have access to it, test it for a couple days, and then return it. The device does work with MVNOs. I bought it full price, so I have it unlocked and it was able to work with US Mobile. I still haven't been able to make it work with Verizon completely, but it does work with calls and texts on the US Mobile network on both the black and the white SIM card. Now, it just may take a little bit longer to unlock for you because of the policy that you need to have it activated. I just asked for a special permission, you know, going hours with customer service. But again, you know, if you want to unlock the device, it's possible to do so. On the side, it has a programmable key, and that is very useful. You're able to use it for different things. Let's say that you want to use it for opening a specific app or things of that nature, then that will be very useful for you. It does have two cameras. It has a camera on the back and a camera on the front. They're nothing stellar. The Xiaomi Chin F21 Pro is a little bit better. Of course, like that one is kind of like false smartphone. I like it better. But for being a flip phone, a rugged device, it has a decent camera. It also has a front-facing camera that if you're using for, let's say, Zoom or, you know, a couple of extra applications that may need that video call setting, then you're able to use them. I like the device. I like the CAT S22 Flip. Very good, very rugged, good battery life. One thing that is also a little bit kind of like on the negative side is the price. So it's $270 with tax included. It's a little bit on the expensive side, but I think it's a worthy device. It's worth what it costs. It's going to last for a long time. It has a very recent version of Android 11, and I think it's going to just be the perfect flip device for a lot of people. It doesn't work, you know, for the privacy-minded, very basic operating system. But for those of you who are looking for a transition device and you've been looking for something that works in the United States or in North America or with the bands that are supported here in North America, then I think the CAT S22 Flip is a home run. Really like the device, very good. And listening to the feedback of the community, CAT has done it because including the touchscreen just makes everything better. If you can get over the price and the heft of the device, then I think this may be an ideal solution for you. If you have any questions or anything else, make sure to put it in the comments below. I'll be interacting with you guys. There's links in there where to purchase and how to do things. And of course, again, if you have anything, make sure to put it in there. See you in the comments.